The Fokker F-28 Fellowship holds a special place in aviation history as one of the pioneering jetliners that catered to the short-haul and regional airline markets. However, lesser known but equally fascinating is the Fokker 614, an aircraft that was conceptualized and designed to cater to a similar segment with some distinct characteristics that set it apart from its contemporaries. The Fokker 614 was born out of a collaboration between the renowned Dutch aircraft manufacturer Fokker and the German aircraft company VFW, Vereinigte Flugtechnische Werke. In the 1960s, there was a growing demand for a short-haul jetliner that could serve smaller airports with limited infrastructure. This need was particularly felt in Europe, where many regional airports lacked the long runways and extensive facilities required by larger jet aircraft. The Fokker 614 aimed to fill this gap. One of the most distinctive features of the Fokker 614 was its engine placement. Unlike most jetliners of its time, which had engines mounted under the wings or at the rear fuselage, the Fokker 614s and 1-2-3-tons were mounted on pylons above the wings. This unusual configuration had several advantages. Firstly, it reduced the risk of foreign object damage, FOD, to the engines from debris on the runway, a common concern for aircraft operating from smaller, less well-maintained airstrips. Secondly, it allowed for a lower ground clearance, making ground handling and boarding easier and more efficient, especially at airports with minimal infrastructure. The engines themselves were Rolls-Royce T. Snecma M45H turbofans, which were designed to provide a good balance of power and fuel efficiency for short-haul operations. The Fokker 614 was designed to carry between 36 to 44 passengers, making it suitable for regional routes with moderate demand. Its design emphasized simplicity and reliability, crucial factors for airlines operating in the challenging regional market. The Fokker 614's maiden flight took place on July 14, 1971, and it demonstrated promising performance characteristics. However, the aircraft faced significant challenges in gaining market acceptance. One major issue was the economic environment of the early 1970s, which was marked by the oil crisis and economic downturns, leading airlines to be cautious about investing in new aircraft. Additionally, the Fokker 614 faced stiff competition from other regional jets and turboprops that were already well established in the market. Despite these challenges, the Fokker 614 garnered attention for its innovative design. It was praised for its short takeoff and landing capabilities, making it particularly suitable for airports with shorter runways. The aircraft also offered a smooth and quiet ride for passengers, thanks to the placement of the engines, which reduced cabin noise. Unfortunately, the Fokker 614's commercial success was limited. Only 19 units were produced, and the program was eventually discontinued in the mid-1970s. However, the aircraft found a niche in certain military and governmental roles, where its unique characteristics were appreciated. Some Fokker 614s were used for training purposes, while others served in VIP transport roles. In retrospect, the Fokker 614 can be seen as a bold experiment in aviation design. Its innovative approach to engine placement and focus on the needs of regional operators were ahead of its time. While it did not achieve the commercial success of some of its peers, the Fokker 614 remains a fascinating chapter in the history of regional aviation. Its legacy is a reminder of the constant quest for innovation in the aviation industry and the challenges that come with bringing new ideas to market. Today, the Fokker 614 is a rare sight, with only a few examples preserved in aviation museums. However, its story continues to inspire aviation enthusiasts and engineers, illustrating the importance of thinking outside the box and pushing the boundaries of conventional aircraft design. The lessons learned from the Fokker 614's development and operational history continue to inform the design and operation of modern regional jets, making it a noteworthy milestone in the evolution of aviation.